with the front. I haven't changed these tyres yet. I might change them for some Maxxis, maybe DHR2, maybe something like that. Something with a bit more grip, that's a bit more aggressive. But yeah, right. Start at the front, same discs. These are Shimano XT single piston brakes with resin pads in them. They are really powerful. I'd like to try the dual two piston, which I think it might be a bit too powerful, I don't know. But 160mm rotor standard. Coming up, you've got a Dior lever, XT, all the adjustment, that's for making the lever go out, which is handy. This is free stroke, so how much you want it press in, so lots of adjustment. And the lawnmower going off now. DMR death grips, these are really worn down, as can't be asked to change them soon though. I'll probably order some more DMRs because they are just really nice. And I have the brake leathers cut off, and I've also glued this because whenever in the Danbury Common video I was doing, it was ratting like crazy in the POV, so I've glued that, so that should not rattle, meaning smoother, just a small smoother ride, well, quieter ride, so people don't look like, what is that? Carrera stem, obviously, because the other one broke. Not really an upgrade, don't really care about weight on this, so roughly the same. Good quality though. Shimano Dior brake. This combo is actually really nice, I find Dior is a bit more softer, which is quite nice because you don't want to keep locking up all the time. Front brakes, this is the XT is more sharper, which is always handy. And zip tied these just to make it look a bit neater. And because I don't have any plugs, I've just zip tied them, black zip ties obviously, around the outside with the brake. But come down here, same cranks and everything. I have left these on because it's not gonna be a dirt. Obviously it's a bit dirty, so, well, it wasn't dirty, it was just the it didn't look very nice with the extra shifter up there for no reason, so I've just cut the wire off and left it in two for now, because that's where the gear you can just go and everything. So next is DMR V11s. I have nicked these off of my C2, but yeah, DMR. These use Allens, I believe. Yep, Allens. And they're 6mm, I think. 6 or 5mm. I think it's 5mm. Really grippy pedals. Pedals that come with this are really bad. So, yeah. Just change them up. Metal. I think these are interchangeable as well, which is nice. Yeah. Coming down here, you got your Dior caliper. The piston, single piston, or two, and resin pads, same disc, 160mm, which is absolutely fine for the rear. Tire pressure wise, I run roughly 40 psi just so I can get extra rolling resistance, and I do not want to get a puncture. So, but you can run lower, but you have the risks of getting a puncture. But yeah. And then the paint is just a blue seat, Mafia No Limits seat, perfect seat, absolutely fine, really comfortable. When it gets wet though, I will say it takes a while. Really nice. I think it fits the bike pretty well, not perfectly because of all this stitching, but still. And yeah, that's about it. So blue with the red looks really nice. This is textured a bit. Yeah, they're all textured, I think, all the stickers and that. And just one thing, you can, on the fork you can lock it out, so that's locked, can't press suspension. Don't leave it on obviously when you're going over really bumpy stuff. Yeah. And then you got your preload, over there. You can adjust that if you like. And yes, pretty good bike for what it is. This is part three. I know I said in the last part there was going to be two parts. Well, the first video I said there was going to be two, but this is part three. And yeah, thanks for watching this mini video series on Specialized. I did these like three parts just because I want to get everything about the Specialized. And you will probably have to put some stickers, something around there so it stops rubbing. Don't know if you can see that to get a better view. But yeah, when it comes to stock, make sure you put something there so it stops rubbing. Comes with like a padded sort of thing for so your paint doesn't get damaged. Might make that a bit thicker because it's really loud. The chain like slaps all over the place, doesn't make very nice noise. But yeah, that's about it. Normal wear and tear, I mean, you got loads of scratches over it. I mean, I've used this for a year and a half. Everything still works really well. So obviously if it works well, don't bother fixing it. Apart from grips, they're really worn out, obviously. Need to change them at some point. That was even worse, so it's all the way down to the plastic. Yeah, that's the end of the video. And mineral fluid, same rule then. It's not like dot fluid, I think, SRAM tank. So just keep that in mind. And shifting, that's for low gear, I believe. And then this one's around here, high gear. And yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching this mini series, and I'll see you in the next video, which will probably be a Danbury Common video. If not, then I'll see you in whichever video it is. See ya, remember to like and subscribe.